Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Mary. In this video, I'm going to talk about makeup and skincare expectations which people have, everything that you need to know and everything that should be addressed. So let's discuss about some makeup related expectations which people have. When it comes to discussing expectations of people which people have related to things, it often correlates with the ideologies behind it and the ideas that we've been living with. So I wanted to address this first, that a lot of people directly and indirectly promote this idea that if you're without makeup you look ugly and with makeup you look beautiful. There's this lot of videos that indirectly in a way promote these ideas, so it somehow over a period of years goes in our mind and then it forms certain expectations in our mind. So that is one thing I wanted to address. All I would say is that such kind of ideas should not be promoted. It's totally a person's choice whether they want to put on makeup or not. That doesn't make you less beautiful. Most popular idea is the promotion of skin lightening products. If you check YouTube, videos related to skin lightening will have millions and millions of views. That is because people like to watch them. The promotion of this idea has been going on since forever. There are a lot of makeup companies which make foundation just in two or three shades. It's not available for all, that is one thing. It has been changing since a few years, which is a good thing. You can't blame the companies only for this, because people don't like to wear foundations of their own skin tone, prefer going for lighter shades of foundation, and which is why lighter shades sell more and then they produce more of it. So this is an idea which has to be changed, not just on the side of these makeup companies but on the side of people as well. It somehow works in a way that makes you feel confident, that if you have a lighter skin tone then it makes you confident. You can understand from the way these fairness creams are promoted in the market, so that goes inside our brain. So I don't promote the idea of lightening of your skin. First of all, that is a big scam, because that is not something that can happen with any skincare products. You cannot change the tone of your skin. Yes, definitely you can get rid of tanning if you have it on your skin, but you cannot completely change your skin tone. All these fairness creams, whatever they promote, first of all they don't work. Secondly, that is not right. So we should stop promoting and believing in such kind of ideas. Next is a very important point which I want to address, is the expectations which people have with relation to makeup. A lot of people don't understand how it exactly works, but people don't understand that makeup cannot conceal each and everything. Skin concerns which cannot be hidden using makeup. So if you have certain bumps on your skin like this, makeup cannot hide bumps on your skin. It can only hide the redness which it has. Another thing which cannot be hidden is pitch scars. Certain acne scars which are left behind after the pimple goes away can be hidden because it's just like a spot. Okay, it's just like a spot. It is a redness or some dark spots. So those things can be hidden, but pit scars, the scars which go a little bit deeper in your skin, those things cannot be hidden, because if there is some sort of a texture will be visible. The discoloration can be hidden and discoloration can be corrected, like if there is darkness, there's pigmentation, or if there is some form of redness, those things can be hidden, but not pit scars and bumps on the skin. In short, what you can conceal using makeup is any form of discoloration, any redness, any pigmentation, dark spots, uneven skin tone. Those things can be evened out using makeup. Let's talk about another important stuff which a lot of people don't know about. You see all these Instagram influencers, all these videos of these influencers, YouTubers, you kind of over a period of time, as you keep watching their videos, you tend to notice that their skin looks absolutely perfect without any imperfections. You start feeling that your skin is not so perfect, and these YouTubers, influencers, they have absolutely perfect skin, and you start feeling insecure about it. The thing is that a lot of Instagram users and YouTubers, they use beauty filters in their videos. First thing is, use of all these beauty filters, it makes the skin look perfect. Another thing is the artificial lighting that is used, which I used to. I don't use any kind of other filters, but I use light. Okay, so when you use artificial light, it somehow shows, it gives a glow kind of thing on the skin. Right now, there's no makeup, but there is, you can see this glow. It is because of the light. So the light automatically makes the skin look good, and it does not show all those texture and other imperfections on the skin. It some hides it to a certain extent. This is one thing which people don't know about, and then they feel that okay, there's something wrong with their skin and they need to fix it. Yeah, sure, if you have certain skin concerns, you can treat it and it's absolutely fine. But don't think that everybody has perfect skin. Nobody has perfect skin, and it is just the use of certain filters and lights that make the skin look good. Let's talk about skincare now. There are certain skin concerns which cannot go away completely. Like there are certain scars which just stays. Skincare products don't work on them. They can only be removed surgically. So certain things you have to learn to live with, or you can remove it surgically. It's your choice. Like I have a lot of pit scars on my cheeks here, and I have a big scar over here which is not visible on the camera. I got this many years back in school when I got chickenpox. Still not visible clearly. If I come closer, only then you can see it. That is how light works. The artificial light is not used only for this purpose. It is used for light, because if you record a video without the light, then it's going to look very dark. So artificial light is needed to record videos. So talking about expectations, so you need to understand that nobody has perfect skin. So have realistic expectations out of makeup and skincare. Once you start understanding these things, it will be much easier and you to understand the way things work. In terms of expectation, there's another thing that whenever people try something new in terms of skincare, they feel that it's going to work magically, and just by using it once or twice, it's going to start showing results. But that is not how things work. Not just skincare, but any shampoo or hair care related product or any other product, it takes time for it to show any kind of visible results. So don't expect results in just 1-2 use, especially if you're using some kind of organic or Ayurvedic products. It takes time to show results, so you have to keep using it consistently. Another thing is, a lot of these products, they do make a lot of claims. All the claims cannot be fulfilled. A lot of companies do go overboard with the claims that they make about their products. Just don't blindly believe anything that they write on their packaging. Set realistic expectations out of products that you use. Another thing which I tell in all of my videos is always read the ingredient list, no matter which product you're buying. For like dark circles and pigmentation is not something that will go away overnight. Even if there are certain things that work, they do take time to show results. So make sure that you allow your skin that time and set the right expectations. Check the ingredient list before making any purchase. So that is all I wanted to discuss and share in this video. I do have a lot of DIY and skincare tips and makeup related videos. If you are new to my channel, you can check them out from the description box below. I hope you found something useful, something of value from this video. Please do like and subscribe to my channel for more such videos, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.